All right, we're back at McMahon Stadium. For those of you checking us out live streaming here on YouTube, Calgary Colts football. Had a little technical problem there. Hopefully we're coming through for you. As we enter second quarter action, Colts 17, Wildcats nothing. Cats in punt formation. Pounds the ball deep, fielded by Niedermeyer, number 17. He's up to the Wildcat 50. All the way down to the 47-yard line of the Cats, tackled by Jeremy Amiss, number 18 of the Wildcats. Seventeen is Dallas Burke. That's a correction on that punt return. It's Burke, number 17. In any event, Colts first and 10. We got a penalty flag on the play as well. So the Colts will have excellent field position to start this drive as they start the first or the second quarter. Pardon me. The ball is going to be spotted down to the 32-yard line of the Cats. So a good punt return is augmented by that penalty, and the Calgary Colts offense sets up shop already in great position. Wasdell fakes the handoff, throws the out pattern, caught number 12 on the reception. Richard Sindani, leading receiver for the Colts. He runs an out pattern there. Nice hands as the route was well covered. He just went up and took that away from the defensive back there. Picks up 9 yards, leaves the Colts in a nice second and one. Playbook's wide open for Wasdell. He's going to hand it to Ramsey. Looks to the right, cuts it up the middle, picks up the yardage necessary for the first down. He's tackled there by 46. It's Jeremy Fagnan, linebacker, having a good day for the Wasdell comes out with three receivers to the left. All kinds of movement again. I don't know if that play was changed at the line of scrimmage, but the offensive line jumped there. This one's probably going to be against the Colts. It is the signal there for procedure. And the Colts will get second down again. We're second and 15 now. Wasdell goes, trips left. He's in shotgun. Single back. Empties the backfield. Back to throw. Looks down the sideline. Got a man wide open. Touchdown, Colts. Dylan Schrott. That was a blowing coverage. Schrott just ran down the sideline. Nobody within 10 yards of him. And Wasdell just lays it in. Perfect throw. Pitch and catch. Colts major. Wildcats blown coverage on that play. And Schrott finds the end zone. Making it look easy there for the Colts. It's a little pitch and catch. And they're up 23-0 early in the second quarter. Convert is good. 24-0 Wildcats, or excuse me, 24-0 Colts with 12 minutes still to play in the first half. So Colts all over the Edmonton Wildcats thus far in Prairie Junior Football Conference action. So once again, if you're tuning in, we're having a little technical issue here. If you're getting the audio, we're trying to fix that as quick as we can. Nevertheless, I'll do my best to describe the action to you. It's 24, Wildcats, nothing. 12:34 left in the second quarter. It's been all Calgary Colts thus far in this game. Scoring two majors offensively, one defensively. Reese Sampson on an interception return. Chip in a field. Colts onside, going short. Not sure why they're kicking the ball short. Maybe trying to catch the Wildcats. Is a flag down, nevertheless, on the play. I don't know if that one went 10 yards. It might have been touched by a Colt player before it traveled 10. Colts maybe saw a hole there in the Wildcat kick return team as they tried the onside kick. So referee's meeting about this one.
Yeah, so it just froze.
I would think that would be an illegal kick because I don't think it went 10 yards before it was touched.
Okay, is it easier to tell now or? Okay, see you
later. A little bit of a surprise there with the Colt defense playing as well as they are to try that short kick. At this point in the game,
you're good, Doug. I'll be here in 2 seconds.
I think we're going to have to do this all over again and re-kick the ball, as it appears the Wildcats are dropping back in their kick return unit. A little bit of confusion here. We'll give a little shout out to our officials association. They never get any credit. These guys do a great job. They do the right thing there. They met. Talked it over, figured it out, and made the right call, which was an illegal kickoff by the Colts. We'll be marched back, and we'll do it all over again. Once again, if you're just joining us for this Prairie Junior Football Conference game, it's been all Calgary Colts thus far. 24-0 over the visiting Wildcats. Colts just kicking off after their last major. This time they do kick it deep all the way down to the 10-yard line. An excellent return all the way out to the 40. A little bit short. It would have been a first down had he been able to come up with that catch, but it hits the turf, and the Cats looking at kicking the ball away. So tough sledding here in the first half for the Edmonton Wildcats, as they've been unable to muster any points. They haven't even been able to get the ball over the midfield into Colts territory. But once again, lots of football left to be played. And the Wildcat kick is deep downfield and on the 30-yard line. He's up to the 40, all the way to the 42-yard line for Dallas Burke, number 17 of the Colts. Penalty flag there. May have been a late tackle there. Late hit. But Burke has a 12-yard return. Actually, the penalty is going against the Colts.
Yeah,
Colts called for an illegal block, a clip on that return by Burke. So the Colts will scrimmage first and 10 on the 26-yard line. Ball's down on the quarterback. He's in shotgun, takes it, fakes the handoff, slides to his right. He's going to tuck it and run. He's out to the 30, to the 35, all the way up to the 44-yard line before being forced out of bounds by number 17, Zeroni of the Cats. So it's a first down Colts as Bailey Wasdell lets his legs do the work there. Chased out of the pocket, didn't have a receiver open, tucks it under his arm, and a nice run by Wasdell, showing that he can take off when he needs to, and he's pressured. And he has first down yardage. Wasdell. He hands the ball off straight up the gut to Minshell. Dylan Minshell picks up about 5 yards on the play. Jeremy Fagnan in on the tackle for the Edmonton Wildcat defense. Second and 5, Calgary Colts. 48-yard line. This offense having a great first half here. High snap, but Wasdell fields it, gives it to Minshell. He's close to the first down chain marker. Jeremy Fagnan, tackle for the Cats. He's all around the football from his linebacker spot this afternoon. It's going to be a little bit short. Third and about half a yard. Colts leaving the offense on the field. They're just going to forge ahead as Wasdell takes the snap, puts his head down, and buries it for the quarterback sneak. He's got the ball over the midfield stripe. That's a first down, Calgary. A good push there by the offensive line of the Colts, driving that Wildcat defense off the ball. They're looking a little tired. They've been on the field a lot this first half, the Wildcat defense. First and 10, Colts. Wasdell fakes it. Fires the ball complete to number 7, Dylan Schrott. Schrott caught the last major score from Wasdell in the series in the end zone. This time he runs a quick slant. It's a gain of 8 yards. Nice first down play for the Colts, leaving them 2nd and 2. And the playbook's wide open. Wasdell once again in shotgun. He's going to hand the ball off straight up the middle. Good yardage for Dylan Minshull. He's down to the Wildcat 38-yard line. Aquil Ambrose, D lineman number 90, one of the tacklers there for the Cats. A methodical little drive going here for the Colts as they hammer the ball on the ground. A couple short passes. And they've got the ball on the Wildcat 39-yard line, 1st and 10. Split backs this time. They run that cross action to Ramsey. He's got some room, dances down to the 35, and he's out of touch at the 32-yard line. Penalty flags fly. This one's probably for a hold, as those flags came out as soon as Ramsey touched the football. And that's what it is, a holding call against the Colts. So this one will come back. Colts run game looking very sharp this afternoon, aside from that holding call that they just got. They're running a nice cross action and utilizing both backs, Ramsey, Minshull, very effective on the ground today. Keeping the defense off balance, not knowing who's going to be carrying the football. And of course, Wazdell can throw the ball. He's thrown for over 1,000 yards thus far this season for the Colts. So pretty exciting offensive group. They run a little swing pass here on first down to Ramsey. That one's tracked down nicely. Another flag flies. It's Jeremy Fagnan. Once again, Fagnan's been on the ball all afternoon. That's his fourth or fifth unassisted tackle as he chases down Ramsey on the swing pass. And the Colts getting a little sloppy here and charged with another holding call. So it's second and 20 yards to go for the Calgary Colts. Ball's on the Wildcat 50. And the Colts want to talk about this one. They call a timeout. Prairie Junior Football Conference, always exciting. Calgary Colts presently in first place. Saskatoon Hilltops in second and the Regina Thunder in third. Huskies in fourth. Winnipeg Rifles in fifth, and the Wildcats in sixth place. Colts offensive coordinator Ian Couture talking things over with his quarterback Wazdell. And the Colts come out second and 20. I'm thinking they're going to throw the football. Wazdell takes a snap. He's pressured, scrambles, fires up the field. Ball's caught. And then dislodged, 85, Curtis Argeo with the catch. And number 11, Brady Kerr, puts his helmet right on the football. A tech defensive back play there by Kerr. Pass is incomplete. Third down. A good defensive stand for the Wildcats. They blanketed the receivers there. Wazdell had nowhere to go. Does find Argeo, but Kerr knocking the ball out. Colts punting. That punt is fielded by Isaac Fagnan, 85. Of the Wildcats. He's out to the 24-yard line. It's about a 7-yard return for the Cats. And they'll bring their offense out with 6:30 left in the second quarter to try to get something going against this Colt defense. Eric Hipp has been under siege the last couple of possessions for the Wildcats as the Colts D-line has had their way. Hipp back to throw. Fires down the middle. Penalty flag flies. He was trying to hit Luther Kunavanhu. Ball was a little bit behind him. Colts charged with play, roughing the passer, as that hit was a little bit late on Hipp. Colt and Hipp standing in the pocket there as it broke down. Fires the ball, but then gets a late hit. So that'll be a first down for the Cats. And they'll gladly take that one as they're out to the 30, their own 39. First down, flags fly again. as both teams showing a little bit of lack of discipline here, as you might expect with the score as it is late in the first half. Hard line. Colton Hipp in shotgun. He's going to hand it up the middle. Nowhere to go there. Colts defense all over number 20. I'm sorry, I'll check that number for you. It's Yacheco, Donovan Yacheco, running back number 20. He loses a couple yards on that play. Justin Keys, one of the Colt defenders in on the stop. Second and 13. Hip back to throw. Number 5 looks down the middle. He's got a man just out of reach of Luther Hakunavunhu, number 81. He's running a post route down the seam. Looked like he had a little bit of room. That ball just a little bit too far for him. And the Wildcats once again send the punt team out. So Cats back to punt from their 20. That's a nice high kick. Fielded by Jordy Kimbamba, number 9. Good coverage by the Wildcats there on that punt. Colts first down and 10 on their own 35-yard line. It's a handoff. No, it's a fake handoff as Wasdell pulls it out, scrambles, throws, complete. Oh, incomplete. I thought that he had that football. Jesse Kuntz, number 19, hit him in the numbers. Hit Kuntz in the numbers at the 50. He had the first down. I think he just turned his eyes upfield. He wanted to run for a little more, and the ball squirts out incomplete. Tough break for Kuntz. He ran a nice route there. Ball was delivered on time and on the money, but it's incomplete. Colts benefiting from a flag here anyways as the Wildcats get pushed back on the penalty. And it's a first down for the Colts. I didn't see the call there. But it's first and 10 Colts on their own 51. Wasdell, high snap. Another flag flies. That play's blown dead before it gets going. So we're getting, as I said, a little sloppy here and late in the second quarter. Both teams picking up flags on consecutive plays. And really taking the rhythm out of time being. Colts called there for procedure. It's the third procedure of this afternoon. First and 15. Bailey Wasdell runs three receivers to the right. Stops, turns, fires the ball to Jesse Kuntz. This time he hangs on to it. Isaiah Brown makes sure that he's down. Kuntz picks up on that one. Running that curl route. Makes it second and 7. And a bit of tempo now as they go hurry up late in the half. High snap. Wasdell fakes the handoff. Fires it upfield. Nice defensive play there. Kerr of the Cats. He stuck his hand in there to knock the football away from Dylan Schrott. So Brady Kerr, that's his second breakup of a pass play by the Wildcat defense. Good coverage there by Kerr. Colts third and eight. Punt team is out. It's a high kick taken by Isaac Fagnan on his own 18. He's out to the 24-yard line for a 6-yard return. And that was Liam Duker, number 89, down on special teams there. Well, Cats, first and 10 with 2:28 left in the first half. Cats trying to get something done. Colton Hip, he's got a receiver open. Lots of room. He's down to the 50 of the Colts. 40, 35, 30, all the way down to the 30-yard line. Donovan Yacheco, running back, slips out of the backfield. And Yacheco has a green grass in front of him as he finds a little gap in the Colt defense there. So a promising play here for the Wildcats as they bring the ball down to the Colt 30 on the strength of that Yacheco pass and run. Let's see what they got up their sleeve now. Colton Hip rolls out to his right. He's got a receiver open. Catches it, breaks one tackle. That's Isaac Fagnan, 85. Check that. It's number 33, Lucas Howe. He runs a little curl route. Colton Hip finds him. And the Cats call a timeout there. Colts charged with defensive holding on that play. So this will continue the Wildcat drive. Ball spotted on the Colt 20. It's first and 10. Ball's on the left hash. Cats looking for their first points of the afternoon. Colton Hip at shotgun. Hands the ball up the middle, nothing there. It's Delnea, the ball carrier. Nowhere to go. Justin Keys riding to the turf. Great big defensive end on your back. Nowhere to go for Delnea. Loses a yard, second and 11 for the Wildcats. Cats go three receivers to the wide side. Colton Hip back to throw. Pressure. He can't get this one away as it's batted down at the line of scrimmage. J-Man Pelly and Justin Keys causing a little havoc in the Wildcat backfield as Colton Hip. And that ball gets batted down. So Colt bend, but they don't break. And they force the Cats into a third down situation. James Barnsley, number 37, comes out for the Wildcats. He's going to try a 28-yard field goal attempt. Ball's in the left hash. Barnsley's kick is up, and he splits the upright. So the Wildcats are finally on the board. 28-yard field goal by Barnsley. And they break the goose egg, 24-3 Colts, 1:22 left in the first half here at McMahon. So a good little drive by the Wildcats there. And that was punctuated by that Yacheco pass and run from Colton Hipp. Yacheco slips out of the backfield, number 20, Donovan Yacheco. And he had 60 yards. He almost scored, but he brought the ball down into scoring position for that field goal. Colts now take the field, gives the ball to Minshull. That's Wasdale, still a quarterback. Dylan Minshull takes it up for 5 yards. Second and five, Colts into their hurry-up offense. Good time to work on this. In the latter half of this first half, this time they hand the ball to Ramsey. He's out to the 45-yard line, close to first down yardage. Ramsey's wrestled to the turf by Jeremy Fagnan. Tony Savchuk also assisting on the stop from his safety spot. They're having a good look at this one. And they may have to measure. And they do bring the chains out. Just a wee bit shy of the first down. And, of course, we all know it's a game of inches. Third and inches for the Calgary Colts. Ball's on the 45-yard line. And they're going to leave their offense out here. And I'm sure Wasdale's going to forge ahead as he does. He rams it forward for a gain of one. And the Colts will continue this series. Under a minute now in the second quarter. Colts, first and 10. Wasdell's back to throw. He's got pressure. Dumps it out to Ramsey. He's out to 50. A good shoestring tackle there on Ramsey. That's number 40. Fagnan again. He's all over the field, sideline to sideline today. Jeremy Fagnan, number 45 for the Cats. And he trips up Ramsey, who's very elusive when he gets some space. So nice play by the Wildcat defender there. Second down. Lo and behold, another penalty flag. This one's against the Colts. They'll get marched back to their own 36. First and 10. First and 20. Check that with the penalty call. Wasdale big rolls out to his right. He's being hurried. Dumps it off. Intercepted. But I think he stepped out of bounds. He did. It's Jaden Dulke, number 21, picks the ball off. But he jumps and he lands out of bounds. So that one just goes as an incompletion for Wasdale. Lucky for the Colts, that would have gave the Wildcats a chance to maybe get some more points here before the half. Second and 20. Wasdell back to throw. He's got a man open. Guns it to number 21, Dylan Minshull, the running back. Brought down by a host of Wildcat defenders. Brady Kerr leading the way. He gets about 9 yards back, but Colts looking at kicking the ball away here with 26 seconds left. No need to gamble at this stage of the game with the big lead. Cats may have a chance for two or three plays. Third down, Colts in punt formation. That kick's taken by Isaiah Brown. He runs all the way across the field as flags fly. Brown caught the ball on the far left hash. And he goes sideline to sideline. Runs about 50 yards, but picks up maybe five. Penalty flags fly again. So that punt took up 15 seconds, something the Wildcats didn't want to happen, and then they pick up a flag for an illegal block, so they're not going to have much time to do anything here, and they're just going to take a knee with 9 seconds left in the half. It does take a knee as the clock winds down, and they'll have to do it one more time here as we go to halftime. So that ends the first half here at McMahon Stadium. Calgary Colts 24, Edmonton Wildcats 3. It's been all Colts thus far in today's Prairie Junior Football Conference action. Please stay with us for second half action. Steady.
Quite a few easy tap ons today, like Chad, no true, like Dave's good notes and stuff. Oh, yeah, make sure this is what we're doing.
Yeah, we've been Dave. We're doing good.
Spit out all that kind of stuff. Stuff, but like seeing this and then like what's going on there, like next year for fundraising, you include paint tickets, that, and then you include easy seats and some stuff that we can do. Just how it was now, it was 23,000.
And welcome back to McMahon Stadium. If you're following our live broadcast of the Calgary Colt Edmonton Wildcats Prairie Junior Football Conference game, we're just at halftime here. Colts 24, Wildcats 3. Teams are just coming back onto the field for the second half, which will kick off in about a minute or two. We'll just run down some stats from the first half of play. Attempts picked up 68 yards, and his longest run was 26. For the Wildcats, it was quarterback Colton Hipp. He had one for 3 yards, but Damian Delnea, running back, touched the rock 6 times for 14 yards. And Delnea's longest was 11. Not a lot of rush yards for the Wildcats. In the passing game, Bailey Wasdell slung it 14 times. He completed 7 of those for 80 yards. Colton Hipp for the Wildcats fired the ball 8 times, and he completed 4 of those for 50. And his total yardage was 77 yards in the air. For pass receiving, Dylan Schrott, number 7 of the Colts, 2 receptions for 31 yards and a touchdown. And for the Wildcats, Donovan Yacheco had 1 reception, but that was a big one. He picked up 57 yards, and that did set up the Wildcat field goal. Of other note, Reese Sampson had an interception for the Colts, and he returned that one 39 yards for the major score. So once again, Colts 24, Wildcats 3, as we head into the second half this afternoon at the stadium. So Calgary Colts coming out for the second half, looking to move to 6-0 with a victory here this afternoon and a sole lock on first place in the Prairie Junior Football Conference. Heading into their final two games of the regular season. Winnipeg Rifles are here next Sunday at McMahon Stadium for a date with the Colts. And the Prairie Junior Football Conference will be in playoffs mid-October, as they traditionally wrap up their year a little bit quicker than the university level or the Canadian Football League level. All Colts in this one thus far. We'll see if the Wildcats can make a statement in the second half and try to claw their way back into this football game as we're ready to go. Colts kicking off to the Cats. Isaac Fagnan of the Wildcats returns that kick out to the 33-yard line. That's a 23-yard return for Fagnan. And the Wildcats in their blue and gold will take the field. And we'll see if they've made any adjustments at halftime to try to figure out this Colt defense, which really held them at bay throughout that half. A flag on the kickoff, and it is against the Colts. The Wildcats have elected to re-kick the football, so both teams send out their respective special teams units to do this one again. So Stephen Fabian will tee it up on the 40 this time for the Colts. And he booms it down to the 15. It's fielded by Vagnan. Once again, he's out to the 30, to the 35. And he's out to the 40-yard line for Vagnan on the return. He's met there by a number of Calgary Colts. Denny Sekic, number 95. One of the tacklers down there. He's assisted by number 21, the running back. Wildcats scrimmage, first and 10, just outside of their own 40-yard line. Got Colton Hip, number 5. Check that. It's a new quarterback. Austin Erickson, number 14, coming out for the Wildcats the second half. And he's met by Mr. Jamin Pelly. So not a great start for Erickson. He drops back to throw the football. And Pelly manhandles the offensive line of the Wildcats. And Erickson's sacked for 4 yards. Wildcats coming out again, second and 14 now. Erickson in the shotgun, empties the backfield, back to throw. He's rushed and he's hit again. This time it's Austin Daisy, number 45. He was shaken up in the first half. Obviously he's okay as he's back into the game, comes off the edge, and he takes Erickson down. So two successive plays. Two quarterback sacks by the Colts. Wildcats not able to move the ball at all on that first series as they feel the pressure of the Calgary Colt defense. Third down and 19 to go. Wildcats in punt formation. Jordy Kimbaba fields the punt at his own 40, brings it out to about the 48. And the Colts will have good field position to start their opening drive of the second half. Hand off to Ramsey. He's got a gain of about 4 yards. Now at quarterback for the Colts is number 10, Duncan Little. So Wasdell gets a well-deserved rest, and Duncan Little gets some meaningful reps here at quarterback as the backup comes out to start the second half for the Calgary Colts. And his first handoff to Ramsey, second and 7. And there's a timeout on the field. Some personnel changes on both sides of the ball. So both the Colts and the Wildcats with a quarterback change at halftime. Again, trying to get some repetitions for their backup quarterbacks. As you never know when you might be called upon into action. So Little playing now for the Colts and here for the Wildcats thus far in the second half. Ball's on the 52-yard line of your Calgary Colts. It's second down and 7. Duncan Little in the shotgun at quarterback. Takes the ball, hands it off to Minshull. He's straight ahead down to the 46-yard line of the Wildcats. That's enough for a first down. Penalty flags do fly in the Colt backfield. And this one will be coming back. Colts called for the illegal procedure there. New quarterback in the game. Sometimes the cadence is a little bit different. Lots of reasons why they may have jumped there. But this will make it second and 12. The Colts. Little fakes the handoff, sets up, throws. He's got a man open. It's Dylan Schrott. He's got it. He catches the football. Schrott running a post pattern, catches the ball down on the Wildcat 27-yard line. A nice pitch and catch. Duncan Little, Dylan Schrott. It's about a 43-yard pickup there, Little to Schrott. Nice pitch and catch, well-designed play. And Little's got the Colts down in scoring position. This time he hands the ball to Minshall. He's down to the 20, to the 15. Still going, keeping the feet going. Minshall, a nice run off left tackle. Shredding that Wildcat defense. Jaden Delke eventually pulls Minshall down. But he's got the Calgary Colts. In scoring position, first and goal on the 9. So the Colts alternate quarterbacks, but they don't miss a beat here on this offensive drive. And Little's got the troops in scoring position here. Takes the handoff, little cross action, gives the ball to Minchell. He's in for the touchdown. Dylan Minchell, number 21, takes it 9 yards up the middle. Tripped up on the goal line, but he's into the end zone for the Majors. So on their first offensive possession of the second half, Calgary Colts, with Duncan Little at the helm, drive the ball 65 yards. And punctuate that with a Dylan Minchell run for the major score. That convert's good, and the Colts open up a 4-touchdown lead, 28-point lead, 31-3 with 10:23 left to play in the third quarter. Lots of time as the Colts pad their lead here. So Stephen Fabian getting lots of work today as the kickoff specialist for the Colts. He tees it up on the 45, and he's ready to pound this one. And it's a nice kick down the middle. Ball takes a funny bounce back towards the Colts, and it looked like no Wildcat really wanted to pick that football up. They do recover the ball as number 22, Isaiah Brown, appears to have jumped on it. But it squirted around there for a minute, and the Wildcats looked a little confused as to who was going to pick up the football, and the Colts almost recovered it. So that would have just rubbed a little salt into the wound here in the second half. The Wildcats do retain possession. First down, they're on their own 26. Erickson, a quarterback, gives to Delnea, number 28, off the right side. Nowhere to go. Austin Daisy meets in there. Delnea's got a gain of about 2 yards there for the Cats. It'll be second and 8. 14, Austin Erickson in at quarterback, replacing Colton Hipp in this second half. He's in shotgun. He fakes the handoff, throws the ball deep downfield, nowhere near the intended target there. Luther Hakanuanhu, number 81, leading receiver in this Wildcat offense. He was well covered. The ball was about 10 yards out of his reach. So another two and out for the Cat offense. They're really struggling here this afternoon against this first place Colts defense. And it's another punting situation. That kick is taken by Jesse Kuntz, number 19. He's got about a 5-yard return for the Calgary Colts. And good field position once again. This field position battle has been all Colts this afternoon. They've consistently started in front of their own 30. Duncan Little hands the ball off to Ramsey. Cuts right back to the left. He's quick. makes a move. Down to the Wildcat 50-yard line. A gain of 20 for Ramsey. He's elusive as he went to his right and then he saw daylight to his left, cuts back, and Ramsey picks up 20 yards and a first down for the Colts. As that offensive line continues to punch holes in the Wildcat defense, and Minshall and Ramsey are having a field day here. Duncan Little, it's a high snap. He's got a man wide open all the way down. Wildcat, 23-yard line. It's 87. Evan Mann, first catch for Mann this afternoon. He just ran a quick slant in, and nobody was around him. And Little finds him. Ball's delivered on the money. And the Colts are looking to punch the ball in again. First and 10 on the Wildcat, 25. Duncan's down to the 15. Should have another first down. Dragged down by Jeremy Fagnan, number 45 of the Wildcat. It is a first down, about a 12-yard gain for Minshall. Colts threatening to add to their lead here this afternoon. Little runs to Ramsey. Gaping hole. He went a walk into the end there. Touchdown. And this one's getting embarrassing for the Wildcats as the Colts do what they want to on that series. There's a flag down. That was late in the play. I think that was after the score. But Xavier Ramsey just has nothing but green grass in front of him. I'll give a lot of credit to the offensive line of the Calgary Colts this afternoon. Yeah, there's been all kinds of room out there for the running backs, and they're really manhandling this Wildcat defense. And that convert is good. Calgary Colts, 38. Edmonton Wildcats, 3. And we've got 6:51 still to play in the third quarter. So it was a dead ball foul against the Wildcats after the touchdown. So guess what? The Colts get to kick off from the Wildcat 50. And he booms it down to the goal line, fielded there by 85. That's Fagnan. He's out to the 15, to the 20, cuts it back out to the 25. He's met by a number of Calgary Colts. Dalen Creason, number 20, one of the Colts in on the tackle. Flags fly again late. It was a good return by Isaac Fagnan. He's still fighting for yards there. Showing a lot of pride there for the Wildcats on that kick return. Trying to spark this team and make something happen here in the second half. things go bad, they go bad, and another flag against the Wildcats. So that promising return is negated by the penalty. And the Wildcats got 100 yards to go before they see the Calgary Colt goal line. They're on their own 10. Erickson back to throw. He's got a man open, and he's complete, and that's Yaseko. Donovan Yaseko, 20 reception in the first half for the Cats. He's got about a 17-yard pickup there. Penalty flag comes down. And this one's going to go against the Calgary Colts for a rough play. So that will add 15 tacked on to the gain by Yaseko. So it's a 32-yard pickup in total with the penalty for the Wildcats. That certainly doesn't hurt their cause. First and 10, Erickson brings the troops out on the 42-yard line. Spreads the field, finds a man in the seam. Nice catch, number 81. Climbs the ladder, Luther Hakanuvenhu. He runs a little seam route, and he's got to go up and get that one as the ball was high. That's a sweet catch and probably the nicest play by the Wildcats all afternoon. Wildcats on a roll here on offense as Erickson's back to throw. Fires out into the flat, complete. Braden Olson catches that one, runs a quick curl route. Nice first down call. Erickson throws the ball on time. And the football is on the Colt 41. Second and 5, Cats. Erickson again at the shotgun, empties the backfield. Blitz picked up. Erickson's got a man open. He fires it to the corner to number 1. Oh, Jim. Of his reach, Tristan Schultenkamper. Schultenkamper's running the flag pattern there to the corner. He had a step on the Colt defender, and Erickson just failed to hook up with him. Another piece of nylon down on the turf. Preliminary signs here are against the Colts. So the Wildcats will get another chance at this one. It was a 5-yard penalty, so we're going to be second and maybe a foot to go for the first down as Erickson comes out under center, and he's just going to forge ahead on the quarterback sneak. Stacked up pretty good by the Colts. That'll depend on the mark. I don't know if he got that one. As Austin Daisy was there, that whole left side of the Calgary Colt defense had a good push, and the Wildcats were going the wrong direction there. Indication was that his initial movement was enough for the first down, and then he got driven backwards, but Erickson does pick it up. And first and 10 for the Cats on the 35-yard line of the Colts. A nice offensive series and drive here for the Wildcats. We'll see if they can continue it here. Back to throw, feeling some pressure. He's not going to get this football away as Erickson goes down. Number 94, Chris Pete Schwartz. He's been causing havoc all afternoon, as that whole defensive line has for the Calgary Colts this afternoon. Denny Sekic, Jamin Pelly, Chris Pete Schwartz, Justin Keyes, Dallin Leland, Devin Southwell. They've all been involved. And that's why there's only 3 points on the board for the Wildcat. Erickson back to throw. He's got a man open. He's complete, close to first down yardage. Yeah, Colton Burr brings the receiver down. It's 33, Lucas Howe, from his wideout spot. He caught the ball up close to the 25 of the Colts and then was backwards by Burr, Colt defenders. They're going to mark it 2 yards short of the first down. No reason to say why the Wildcats would not go for it, as it looks like they are. Third and two on the Colt 28, trailing by 35 points. They need a whole bunch in a little bit of time, so the offense stays out. Empty backfield. Erickson's back to throw. Fires out to the flat. It's over the head of Howe. And I don't know if that was the man they wanted to hit, but he was open, but the pass was over his head. And the ball's going to turn over on downs back to the Colts. So a promising little drive there by the Wildcats. But they stall out on third down. Colt territory at the 28-yard line. Again, Erickson being pressured there by that Colt defensive front. And he was a little bit hurried there. And the ball sailed on him a little bit as he had a man open, Howe in the flat, but could not deliver the rock. Colts now first and 10. Little's going to go deep on first down. Dylan Schrotz, number 7, makes a circus catch. That's a one-hander. I'd like to have another look at that one. Dylan Schrotz runs the sideline, sticks up one hand, and pulls it in. Beautiful catch. Ball was delivered nicely. Schrotz makes an outstanding catch. That's a huge first down for the Colts as Duncan Little is trying to get some reps in, and he's firing the ball. The big quarterback looks good. This time he hands the ball off to Minshall straight up the gut. Minshall's going to go. He's down to the 5. Goal line touchdown. Dylan Minshall right up the gut. 30 seconds. Untouched for the major. Calgary Colts firing on all cylinders today. That offense looks sharp. Ramsey and Dylan Minshall are running roughshod over this Wildcat defense. And Little has shown no signs of slowing down since he's come in the second half, leading the Colts to 2 touchdowns thus far in the third quarter. And they're blowing this one wide open. Colts 45, Cats 3. 2 minutes left in the third quarter. So Calgary Colts looking to extend their season's unbeaten streak. 2-6-0 today. They look to be in a pretty good position to do that right now. And also their undefeated streak here home at McMahon Stadium, which bodes well for playoff action if the Colts can keep this going as they head into the back end of the schedule. Fabian once again kicking the ball off for the Calgary Colts. Isaiah Brown, number 22, for the Edmonton Wildcats, brings it back about 17 yards on that kick return. Latter stages of the third quarter in this one. It's been all Calgary Colts from the opening kickoff. Wildcats, first and 10. Hand the ball to Delnea. Absolutely a stone wall, nowhere to go. Calgary Colts, right side of that defensive line, led by Chris Pete Schwartz, the big D tackle. A loss of a yard. Cats second and 11. Austin Erickson in the shotgun. He's back to throw. Looks down the middle. Fires. Again, not on the same page with number 81, Luther Hakanavanhu. He's tried to find him a couple times now. That one, again, sailing over his head. And this Wildcat offense really looking in disarray at this point in the game. Back to punt. This punt's a wee bit short. Matt Cerrone punting number 17 for the Wildcats. That one a little bit off the side of his foot. It angles out at the cold bench around the 50-yard line. And it's going to be spotted on the Wildcat 48. So once again, the Wildcats conceding some field position here. Colts starting at midfield. Duncan Little at quarterback. He goes under center. He fumbles it and then picks it up. So he fumbles the exchange there under center, then runs it off the left side of the line. Tackled by Travis Louvre, number 70. Little gets about a yard there. Not sure why they went under center since he's been in shotgun the whole game, but. Back to the gun now goes Little, three receivers to the left. Looks for the hitch. Wide open man down the middle. That was 17, Dallas Burke, as that was a nice scheme by the Colts. If that ball's on the money, it's another 6 points, as absolutely nobody was around Burke. No safety there for the Wildcats. I'm not sure what defense they were in there, but Burke's wide open. Little had time. He just missed through the football. Or we're looking at 52 points on the board there. In any event, it's incomplete. And that's the end of the third quarter, so we're going to change ends. Colts 45, Wildcats 3. Fourth quarter action coming up.
Thank you.
Hey, football fans, if you're back with us, I'm Darren Dudar at McMahon Stadium. We're watching the Calgary Colts and the Edmonton Wildcats, and what's been a lopsided affair here this Sunday afternoon. We're just about to start the fourth quarter, teams changing ends. Colts with a 42-point lead. And I haven't quite seen this before in the Prairie Junior Football Conference. Colts are lining up for a 54-yard field goal. Maybe they've been motivated by Rennie Paradis' 53-yarder yesterday, but Fabian's going to try a 54-yarder here on third down. No wind, pins up. He drills it, looks to be a little bit short. Taken on the goal line. Number 22 there on the return, it's Isaiah Brown. Penalty flag down. Penalty flag is down here on that return by Brown, as the Colts' 54-yard attempt is a little bit short. That would have been a hell of a kick in any league. I think Janikowski missed his last 54-yarder for the Raiders. So I'm not going to fault Stephen Fabian on that kick attempt. The Stripes trying to sort this one out as there was a penalty flag down. I think there was two flags, actually. One at the line of scrimmage on the kick and then another one on the return. Colts looking a little bit happy here, so I think they're either going to try this field goal again. They may get the football. We'll find out. It's rough play against the Wildcats, the first sign. And it appears to be a first down for the Calgary Colts. It is. As they change the marker there. So Wildcats penalized on that field goal attempt. And the Colts are going to have a first down on the Wildcat 37. So it just gets worse for Edmonton here. Duncan Little, he's going to chuck it. Downfield, he's got a man down the sideline, number 87. And that's Evan Mann. Man's running a fade down the left sideline here. And the ball was a little bit high and out of his reach. Second and 10. Little goes three receivers to the left. He's in gun. Fires it to Man. Complete. To the 30-yard line. Tackled by Isaiah Brown of the Wildcats. So Evan Mann runs a quick slant. The gain is 8. So it's third down and 2. And the Colts line up for a more makeable field goal of 37 yards. For Stephen Fabian. Ball's down, the kick is up, powers it up through there. That's a nice kick. And it's good, splits the uprights. He had a little spare on that one. But 37 yarder is good. And the Colts pad their lead 48-3 with 13 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. So a long afternoon today for the Edmonton Wildcats. And a very strong showing for the Calgary Colts. And they get a chance to play some of their backup players and some of their developing players in these situations. So a good thing for the Colts. Wildcats just trying to step away with a little bit of pride from this game. You know they're not going to quit. And Erickson fires that first down pass. Incomplete. He's looking for Luther Hakuna Vanhu. Another flag down. It's been a penalty-filled game here this afternoon. This one's probably on the Colts for pass interference. It is. There's the indication from the official. PI on the Calgary Colts. And the Wildcats will be on their own 50. And that's an automatic first down. Austin Erickson in the gun. Sends out six receivers. Finds a man, number 85. It's Isaac Fagnan. He's close to a first down. Dylan Niedermeyer and Colton Burr absolutely hammered him on that play. But he hangs on to the football, and he's close to first down yardage. It looks to be just inches short of a first down for the Cats. But Niedermeyer and Burr laid the lumber down there as Wildcats come out on second and short. They pick up the first down on the quarterback sneak. To me, it looked like the Cats had jumped there. And they may be called on the offside, or it is procedure on the Cats. It looked like the right offensive line was a little bit ahead of the football as they surged forward. Nothing coming easy today for the Wildcats as now they're looking at second down and five. Ball at midfield, Erickson. He's going to fire it out to the flat. He's got his man, Luther. He's down to the 38-yard line of the Calgary Colts, tackled by Brandon Summers. Hakuna Vanhu, number 81, the leading receiver on this Wildcat offense. Cats offense, first and 10 on the Colt, 38. Erickson calling the signals, fakes the handoff. He's tackled in the backfield as he tries to run that read. He pulls the football out, and then he's tackled by Denny Sekic, number 95 of the Calgary Colts. Erickson kind of slipped up there. He couldn't get the ball out quite from the running back. And Sekic was there to pull him down. So the Cats lose six there. Second and 16. Erickson's firing the ball. He's got a man. And it's intercepted. And there's a penalty flag as well. I'm not sure if that ball was intercepted or if the ball went incomplete and a flag was down. It's hard to know. I believe it's pass interference in any event against the Calgary Colts as Austin Erickson was looking for Luther Hakuna Van Hoo, number 81. He was well covered there by Calgary Colt defenders. Noah Williams and Brandon Summers was also in the area. The ball bounced around, and it is PI against the Calgary Colts. So the Wildcats are going to end up with the football, first and 10. So a little discussion here amongst the officials, actually talking to both captains. So pass interference against the Colts. As anticipated, that is the call. And that is the call coming from the field level. Edmonton Wildcats, first and 10 on the Calgary Colt 29-yard line, 10 minutes in the fourth quarter. Cats looking for their first major. They hand the ball off to Del Nia, number 28. He picks up about 4 yards. A Colt defender going down in obvious pain there. And a penalty flag also comes out late in the play there. Dunlea had little to no gain as he was tackled. And I can't quite make out the number of the Colt defender there as he fell down and away from the pile. So he's receiving some medical attention right now. So injured Calgary Colt on the field. The ball spotted down on the 12-yard line, which indicates the penalty was against Calgary. And they've already spotted the chains down on the 12, so that's where the Wildcats will have their first down attempt. Looking for their first major score of the afternoon. Only a field goal thus far in this game. To their credit. Colt defense has been very tough this afternoon. So once again, if you're just tuning in, we got an injured Calgary Colt on the field, and that was the delay in the game here. It is number 48, linebacker Jaden Lawson. So Lawson was down for a minute or so. He's just getting to his feet rather gingerly here. He's walking off under his own steam, albeit with a little bit of a limp. So we hope that he is okay. So Lawson walks his way up off the field there for the Calgary Colts. And the Wildcats threatening for their first major. They're down to the Colt 12-yard line here. And they're going to have three cracks at it. See if they can get a touchdown here on the Colts this afternoon. Erickson is in. Takes the snap, fires the ball down the middle. Behind the intended receiver, 81, Hakuna Van Hoo. He's run that road a couple times today, just a little dig road across the middle, and the ball's behind him. And that one was delivered behind him as well, so no chance catching that football. The timing just out on that play between Erickson and his receiver. Second down. Cats go trips left. Shotgun. They're going to hand the ball off to 85. He's met. Isaac Fagnan gets the football. He's tackled by Austin Daisy, number 45. Daisy was not fooled from his linebacker spot. He came across and sat there. He had contain on Fagnan, so no threat there of a run. But Nylon is down once again. This time the call is holding against the Wildcats. Colts declined that penalty. And it brings up third down. Wildcats send out the field goal team. And it's a 27-yard attempt. And whistle goes before the snap there. And Cats called on a time count. So unable to even get the field goal unit onto the field in time here. As James Barnsley lines it up. He's going to do it again. They're going to have to march it back a little bit. So Barnsley will now try a 32-yarder for the Wildcats. That one's blocked by the Colts. It bounces around on the 10. It's going to be Colts football regardless. So the kick was low. He sort of drove it. It was just over the line, and the Colts got a hand on it, blocked it. Bounces down to the 10-yard line. And then there was a pileup. And Colts appear to have recovered that football. 28, Mark Chamberlain was in the vicinity. I don't know if he was the man that fell on it or not. It may have been Brandon Summers as well, 25. In any event, no points for the Wildcats. And the Calgary Colts will take over the football. Midway through the fourth quarter here with Colts holding a commanding lead, 48-3. In what's been a one-sided contest this afternoon at McMahon. Wildcats probably can't wait for this one to end, and that clock can't really move fast enough in this situation. Ball comes out to the 25. It's first and 10 for the Calgary Colts. Duncan Little still at quarterback. He's gone all the way in the second half, leading the Colts to a couple of scores. He hands that one off to number 31, Jordan Gabriel Cannon, getting some time at running back late in the game. Cannon picks up 2 yards, and it's second and 8. For the Colts. Lots of younger players on the field now for the Colts. And good to see them getting a chance to play here this afternoon. Little fires that one out. He intends that for Gabriel Cannon as well. The running back just running a little out route. Ball's off his hands. You can't pull it in. And it's Colts punt team, Fabian out to kick it away. And we got a timeout on the field. So all Calgary Colts this afternoon, dominating this football game from the get-go. And Wildcats not able to muster much offensively, nor could they stop the Colts defensively. And this one played out as you might expect with the first place team and the Wildcats yet to get a win in the Prairie Junior Football Conference. And it's going to be another week before they get another opportunity for that. 7:55 left to play. Timeout is now over. Colts in formation here. Fabian hasn't had too many punts this afternoon, but he's set to kick this one away. Wildcats get a little bit of pressure, but Fabian does get it away. Drives the ball back to the 45. Fagnan picks it up. Isaac Fagnan, he's out to the 42-yard line. And there's a host of Colt defenders in on special teams there. And they stack Isaac Fagnan up on the 42. And the Wildcats offense will come out again. Austin Erickson runs the zone read. He's going to keep the football this time. He's got a gain of about 6 yards as Erickson tucks it in and runs. Brought down by Mark Chamberlain, number 28. Chamberlain, another St. Francis Brown product. Second and five, Wildcats. Erickson in the shotgun. He's going to chuck it. Looks down the middle. He's got a man open. Incomplete. As the ball again was slightly behind the intended receiver, Tristan Schultenkamper. Schultenkamper gets his hands on it. Cannot pull that one in. Third down, Cats. Both teams making substitutions here on special teams. This player's a little bit of a fire drill running in and out here. Bad snap on the punt. Penalty flags fly. Calgary Colts ready to chalk this one up in the win column with 6:23 left in the football game. They've got a commanding 45-point lead as it was a total domination today from the opening whistle. That punt is taken by 19, Jesse Kuntz. He takes it on his own 30, and he brings the ball all the way to midfield for a 25-yard return. So a nice punt return there by Jesse Kuntz, number 19 of the Colts. And the Colts red and white machine steps out. Ball's at midfield, first and 10. Duncan Little at quarterback. Takes the snap, fires it out to the flat. This one's picked off. And that was an errant throw. And the Wildcats will get their first touchdown on a pick six. It's 4 It's number 4 there. And that's James Enns. James Enns, number 4 of the Wildcats. Little throws an out to the wide side and Enns right in his hands. And he walks into the end zone. Brings it back 55 yards for the Wildcat touchdown. So good on Enns there. That probably shouldn't have been thrown by Little, but he'll have to live with that one as he fires it out to the flat, and that's no man's land if that ball's not in the receiver's hands. And it wasn't. It was overthrown, and Enns picks it off and walks into the end zone. Life for the Wildcats here late in the fourth quarter as they get on the board with that interception, and they now have 10. So 48-10 for the Colts. Duncan Little having a good second half, but he probably wants that throw back when he's looking at that one tomorrow on the film. Wildcats aren't going to give up. And they're lining up like they may short kick this football or onside kick. Now they balance the field a little more. So we'll see if the short kick is on or if the Wildcats are content to kick it away. They still need an awful lot of points to come back, but it looks like they are going to kick it away. It is kick deep down to the Colt 20 and all the way out to the 45 for Jordan Kimbamba, number 9. He's got a 25-yard return. Kimbamba does. And the Colts offense will be first and 10 from their own 45-yard line. With 5 minutes to play in the game. Let's see how Little responds after that last interception. He's going to keep it on the ground as he hands the ball up the middle. Mari Fraser, number 30, gets the call. That's his first carry of the football game. Fraser picks up about 3 yards. Little fakes the handoff this time, rolls out to his right. He's being pressured, guns it to the sideline. And it's incomplete off the hands of the intended receiver, is number 80, James Spencer. Spencer takes a little bit of a hit after the ball deflects off his hands. And it's incomplete third down for the Colts. Flags fly as the Colts punt. Sails deep. A nice kick drives the Wildcats back to their 8, all the way out to the 25. But a penalty flag down at the line of scrimmage here, so see if this one comes back. Isaac Fagden returning that one for the Wildcats. He's slow to get up there after the tackle. So Isaac Fagden's had a busy afternoon returning kicks and punts for the Wildcats. And it looks like he might have to take another one here, as they're going to line it up. And they're going to have to re-kick this one. Colts making substitutions. Don't have the right personnel on the field for that punt. And they only had 11 on there, it looks like. So they take a timeout. And they're going to figure this one out. Late in the game, I'm sure the Colts made a number of substitutions on their punt team. And they want to get the right players on the field for this third down punt. Colts 48, Wildcats 10, 3 minutes and 37 seconds left. A big afternoon for the red and white today. Pretty much did what they wanted to on offense, running the ball, passing the ball. The defense studded up, didn't give the Wildcats any time on pass plays. The D-line played exceptional, a number of sacks. They had a pick six. Just an all-around solid afternoon. There's a good high punt once again, and Isaac Fagan fields it on his 15 up to his 20. To the 25, still fighting. He's snowed under by Reese Sampson. And a number of other Calgary Colts in there on the tackle. Among them, Curtis Argale, 85. Good coverage there by the Colts. Wildcat offense steps out on their own 25. They're first and 10. Pass is complete to number 81, Luther Hakunavanu. He's the favorite target today of Colton Hipp and Austin Erickson, but hasn't had too many catches, as that Colt defense has been tough. This one's good for a first down, though. And Erickson's going to hand the football off. No running room there. Nate Delnea, the ball carrier. Colts D-line. Devin Southwell, number 97. First man to the football. Also, Mike Bright, number 39, getting some reps at D-end. He assists on that tackle. Second and 8 Wildcats. Erickson back to throw. Looks down the middle. Fires it for number 81, Hakunavanu. Unable to catch this one. Good coverage there by the Colts. Chamberlain, number 28, back in coverage. Third and eight for the Edmonton Wildcats as they punt this football away. Jesse Kuntz fields it. He's running wide all the way across the field. Penalty flags fly. He fields it at the 40 and brings it out to the 50. But he runs 60 yards across the field before turning the corner for a short return of about 10. Yeah, Kuntz takes that one on the dead run, so he picks up the no yards call as the Wildcats were inside of the 5-yard restraining zone. Ball's going to be spotted just inside of midfield at the Wildcat 54-yard line. And it's first and 10. Now in at quarterback is, that was Dylan Schrott, number 7, playing quarterback. And he fires his first pass complete to Tarek Anderson, number 16. Dylan Schrott showing some great. Carries a wide out, slot back. And he's made a couple of great catches today. It's got a touchdown to his credit. And now he's playing quarterback. Schrott takes the shotgun snap. Throws a nice ball down the sideline. Looking for Anderson again. That one's well covered by the Wildcat defense. And it falls incomplete. Jaden Dahlke back in coverage, number 21 for the Cats. And also Matt Cerrone, number 18, was in the vicinity. So both teams playing out the string here as we get into the latter half of the game. Under 2 minutes now, Colts punting. And it's a nice high kick, driving the Wildcats back to their own 5. And they push the return out to the 15. Good coverage there by Keys, 92 of the Colts. And once again, there's another penalty flag down on the return. Been penalty flags in virtually every punt and kick return in this fourth quarter, which is probably a sign of a number of substitutes in the football game. This one's going to be spotted back at the 4-yard line. So the Wildcats in the shadows of their own goalposts. With a minute and a half left to play. Erickson standing on his goal line. He's back in the end zone. Look to throw. He's got time. Now he's going to run. He's out to the 10. And that's about as far as he's going to go as the Colts corral him there. Number 43 is Brock Vanderhoek. Erickson runs for 5. Second and 5 Cats. Well, it's certainly a sunny day, but it's been raining flags for this fourth quarter. As Cats are charged with Another penalty, offside or procedure call there. So it'll be second and nine. And rolls out to his left. Plants, fires the football. Incomplete. Looking for a Shelton Camper over his head. Providing coverage where it was Brandon Summers, number 25. Colts 48, Wildcats 10, 1 minute left to play. Cats looking at third down, and they're going to be punting from their own end zone. Matt Cerrone, the punter, running around in the end zone, just killing some seconds off the clock. I'm not sure why he's burning time, but he gives up the two. And we got a flag, so it may not be a safety here. I'm not sure why they just didn't kneel down and then kick the ball off, but in any event, it is a safety touch for the Calgary Colts. Make it an even 50 for the Colts. 50 big points put up by the Calgary Colts today. In a one-sided affair here at McMahon Stadium. The defense did not allow a touchdown today. The only Wildcat major coming on interception, pick six for a touchdown. So the defense holds the Wildcats to a field goal today. Just a stellar effort by the defense. And the offense, well, put up 50 points. They had their way with the Wildcat defense all afternoon. And probably content here to kneel down or maybe just hand the ball off a couple times as Dylan Schrott is the third quarterback to play in this football game for the Colts. Wasdell, Little, and now Schrott, and he does hand the ball off. Straight ahead for a gain of 5 yards. And the running back there is Omari Fraser, number 30. So lots of Colts able to see the field this afternoon in this football game. Schrott hands it off to Fraser again. Nice run. Keeps the legs going. And he picks up a cool first down. Gain of about 9 yards for Omari Fraser, number 30. And nice to see the little bit of depth there for the Calgary Colts at the running back position. As Fraser looks like he's ready to step in a moment. Colts now to take a knee. And that will end this one. Make the final. Colts 50, Wildcats 10. You've been watching Calgary Colts football. Thanks for joining us.